Exactly.
Lots of them.
Yeah, copy and roll.
Hey, they could be bigger and more immediate than the threat of global warming, they say. Earth's magnetic field, which acts as our protective shield in space, has a hole in it. And that could put a lot of our earthly functions at risk. Dr. Michio Kaku, professor and author of the book Physics of the Impossible, is back with us. Professor, how are you? And good morning to you.
Glad to be on the show.
Thanks. Twice in 1 week, man. It's bonus hour.
Mm-hmm.
What is this solar shield?
Well, every 11 years, the sun has a temper tantrum. It releases a shockwave, a tsunami of radiation that could wipe out communication, weather satellites, GPS, spy satellites, you name it, it's up there in outer space. So
you're saying that my BlackBerry won't work?
The internet, Fox, television, cable, satellite TV, all of it could get wiped out around 2012. That's when we have the peak of the sunspot cycle. That's when the sun's magnetic field flips. North pole and south pole flip, releasing a shockwave of radiation, which will then hit the Earth minutes later, potentially wiping out a good chunk of our satellite communications. We're watching it very carefully now.
Well, Doc, this happens how often, you say?
Every 11 years.
Well, However, why an 11-year cycle?
It takes 11 years for the magnetic field of the sun to build up enough intensity to begin the flip process because it slowly revolves in a circle. It's like winding up the windings of a clock. If you wind up the mainspring of a clock too much, it boing, comes out of control. Same thing with the sun's magnetic field. It literally flips every 11 years, releasing a shockwave of radiation. And that means we have to start to think about reinforcing our satellites, building redundant systems, because it means that GPS, the power grid, weather satellites, communication satellites, satellite television, all of that could get disrupted, peaking around 2012.
So your point is we can't do anything about it in space, but we can do something back here on Earth.
That's right.
But backup systems, are companies really doing that?
Well, they're going to have to do it because, see, we scientists made a mistake. We thought that the next cycle was going to be quiet. Well, some of our data was off by a factor of 20, and that's why we're issuing this alert now. We made a mistake. The next cycle, peaking around 2012, will be much more serious than we previously thought. Now, in the past, we dodged the bullet because we didn't have that many satellites up there 11, 22 years ago. Back in 1990, we didn't have that many space satellites.
Well, that makes sense to me. But, you know, I'm listening to you talk. I'm thinking, why 2K? I'm thinking it's just a tactic that put a lot of fear in a lot of people. It may have gotten us ready, but there was really no danger in the end.
Well, let's hope that it's a dud. Let's hope that nothing happens. However, what if our communication systems are wiped out? Billions of economic activity could be jeopardized.
Do you think anyone's taking this seriously?
I think we're going to have to. The physicists are now sounding the alert. We made the mistake. We made the wrong projection. The next solar cycle will be more intense than previously thought. And an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Now's the time to begin to create redundant systems, reinforce our satellites, build backup systems.
All right. Michio Kaku, the word is out. You know, if you render my BlackBerry useless, that's okay. I'm here loud. Do that for a while, then we'll bring it back.
Okay.
Thank you, Doctor.
Mm-hmm.
Nice to know. Meg?
Love him.
Were
he's
you listening?
Great. Yes.
You were?
Yeah.
What did he say?
Just messed it up, and
what
now they have to fix it. And he talked about the Department of Redundancy Department.
Uh-huh, right. It's on magnetic fields,
yeah,
polar opposites,
gotta fix
sun,
it down
Earth,
here.
Right?
When's it going to happen?
11 years apart. 2012 is the next one.
Okay.
So the last one was minor. So the scientists are to blame for that because they underestimated the power. And they think this time it could be the big one.
I think he is the most understandable physicist I've ever had the pleasure of listening to. Am I wrong? Do you guys love him? I think we should make him a Fox News contributor. I've just decided it.